Hi. In this tutorial, we are going to make an object that covers the snow. First, create a material and double-click to open the window. Next, hold down the T key and click to create two texture samples. Apply brick clay beveled and normal provided in start content to the created texture sample. Next, create a text coord node. Hold down the keyboard M and click to create a multiply node and connect it so that you can set the number of UVs. If you create a parameter by clicking it while holding down the S button on the keyboard and connecting it, you can adjust the number of UVs with an instance in the future. Now connect the multiply nodes to each of the texture samples. Next, hold down the number 3 button and click to create a constant 3 vector node. Then, search for transform and click to create a transform vector. Set the blue of the constant 3 vector as 1, connected to the transform vector, and set the value of the transform vector. Since the transform vector sets the coordinates of the world space with the value specified in the tangent space, blue represents the z-axis. Therefore, the height is made at right angles from the center of the material. If you preview the node, you can see the colors on the top and both sides of the object coincide with the respective axes in the bottom left corner. After that, create a component mask node and connect it to extract the blue value from the top. Next, hold down the A on the keyboard and click to create an add node and connect it to the previous node, and then create and connect a parameter to make it possible to adjust the degree of snow cover. Next, create a clamp node and connect it to set a color limit to prevent discoloration. Next, hold down the L on the keyboard and click to create two LERP nodes. After that, connect the previously created nodes with LERP's alpha to separate the snow-covered and non-snowy parts. Next, connect the texture sample and base color as shown in the video to see the snow-covered object on the top. Next, create another texture sample to represent the texture of the snow, and then set the water normal provided in start content. For the last, if you connect to the LERP node and connect to the normal node like in the video, the white part will appear as a water normal and the rest will be like a brick normal. When finished, save it and exit to the content browser. To better see the snow cover effect, you can also place a sphere mesh in the field and then apply a material to the sphere. Now, to check the change, create a material instance and apply it to the object placed in the world. When the application is completed, double-click the instance and open the window. Then, you can check the change by adjusting the parameters. Now that the z-value is fixed based on the world, you can see that the snow is still covered even if you rotate the object. Thank you.